Good morning, and welcome to the Liston B. Ramsey Center on the campus of Western Carolina University. 16 months have passed since the last in-person commencement ceremony at WCU, and we are so excited to finally celebrate our graduates on campus. I'm Josh Thompson. I have the pleasure of serving as the Director of Undergraduate Orientation. Thank you so much for joining us for our pre-show coverage of our undergraduate commencement ceremony for the Colleges of Fine and Performing Arts and Education and Allied Professions. There is no denying that this class of students has experienced college in the most unique way possible. From a solar eclipse to a once-in-a-century pandemic, the class of 2021 has seen it all.
And our newest family members, the WCU class of 2020.
The corona of the sun right now. I am seeing the corona of the sun.
We are 10 seconds away.
I invite all the speakers and the Brown family to join me at the podium to formally reopen Brown Hall.
I'm Allison Morrison Chandler, Interim Chancellor here at Western Carolina University. We're inspired by you coming here. Wear your purple. Proudly be Academite.
Without a new natural sciences building, our growth in these important disciplines will slow to a trickle.
Like, I need to have, I really want this NFL dream to come true. I don't even know, what word can I say?
He took the office of chancellor and he made it into something so much bigger.
Beginning in the fall of 2018, the state of North Carolina will dramatically reduce tuition at three of our public universities.
I can't wait to immerse myself in the total Western Carolina University experience and to meeting more members of my Catamount family.
Not every day that someone gets a dormitory named for them just because she needed 9 hours.
We just did that. We just did that.
We had to do it, though.
We had to do it.
Opportunity of a lifetime. Never forget it.
Together we can build a consistently highly competitive program here across the board at Western Carolina.
That's why we have moved away from face-to-face classes to online learning and other alternative methods whenever possible for the remainder of the spring semester.
Although neither of them attended WCU, they've certainly earned the right to be honorary Catamounts.
What he gives is out of his heart. Bill is a model for many of us to follow.
Western Carolina University has a brand new vaccination clinic open to assist with delivering it to people in the region.
Every student will walk across the stage, pick up their diploma, have a picture with the chancellor, and have their name announced.
As you just saw, a lot has happened since these graduates started their journey here at WCU 4 years ago, or maybe five or six. And it has taken some serious perseverance. We are so excited to celebrate them today, and we have the perfect guests to get us started. When Chancellor Kelly Brown started her journey at WCU, she probably didn't think that her first spring commencement wouldn't happen until almost 2 years into her tenure. But the day is finally here, and we are so excited to have Chancellor Brown and special guest Chair of the Board of Trustees, Bryant Kinney, join us this morning. How are you feeling today, Chancellor Brown, as we prepare for your first spring commencement?
I am so excited. I have gone out and talked to some of the students out in the audience that are the graduates. This is an exciting day. It's exciting for them. It's exciting for Western Carolina University. And it's just so great to see on their faces the smiles and the family members that are here with them today.
Thank you, Chancellor Brown. Bryant, can you talk about how these students have handled the last year from your perspective?
Josh, let me tell you something. I look behind me at this sea of purple, which I always love. It's just so, so awesome. But as a business person, I could not be more excited for the future. And it's simply because of what these kids have been through, what you just saw on that video. I mean, and now we've got a gas shortage and 17-year cicadas coming out. I mean, these kids can get through anything, anything. They're going to turn this world upside down. I am real excited for this generation.
Excellent. Chancellor Brown, besides the crazy world we're in right now, how's it been joining the Catamount family?
It's been amazing. From the very first day of April of 2019, when I was announced chancellor here at Western Carolina University, it's been wonderful. The passion, the pride in Western Carolina University is, as Chair Kenny said, the purple. The purple is everywhere, and we so much appreciate that. It's been wonderful. I've appreciated my whole time here. The next several years are going to be great as well.
Thank you both for joining us today. It's been a real pleasure to have you on the show. It's obvious that the students have had to do some serious grit over the last 4 years, but they haven't done it alone. Countless professors, staff, and family members have been by their side over the last 4 years, and they certainly couldn't have done it without them. We asked a few of our students to write a letter to someone who had a significant impact on their time at WCU. Here's what they had to say.
I'm about to email you something right quick.
Okay.
And I want you to read it.
Do you want me to read it out loud?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay. All right. I'm ready, and I'm good to go. Debbie, I would like to express my gratitude for being one of your students.
Dear Dr. T. Swiggin Davis, thank you. You have given me so much over these past 4 years, whether that be a shoulder to cry on, a listening ear, or even a punch to the gut in the form of a hard lesson you were trying to give me.
I know that teachers like you are not easy to find. Each day you came to class with a smile on your face and kind, encouraging words for each student.
As a mentor, you have helped me to reach new heights in both my academic career and in my community service endeavors. To help in bettering everyone around me and help communities that I serve.
أنا ممتن لوجودكم في حياتي ودعمكم اللامتناهي. وإذن الاستماع كلما تقطعت السبل عني أو احتجت إلى المساعدة أو أردت شخصا قريبا للتحدث معه.
Again, thank you. Just doesn't seem like enough, but thank you for making my time at Western easier, and thank you for being one of the reasons why it would be so hard to say goodbye to my undergraduate life.
Lauren, that is so sweet. You're gonna make me cry.
Thank you very much, and congratulations for you, bro.
Thank you more, because when I entered college, I was just quiet, never talked. And there are people like you who helped me open up and give my heart out to whatever I was doing and to continuously better myself.
Oh, James, I appreciate that. It's been such a gift to watch you walk this journey and to watch you develop as the young man who is going to go out and make some dynamic changes in the world.
This doesn't feel like enough. It really doesn't. I truly, truly appreciate you for everything. Even at times where I was ready to quit and give up, you just kept reminding me that I was here for a purpose, that God always has a plan for me. And I can't imagine what it would have been like without you and your presence in my life. So again, thank you, Dr. Takis.
Hey there. I can't even believe that here we are, ready for commencement already. Grads, we are so proud of all that you've accomplished during this crazy, unpredictable year. You have demonstrated grit and resiliency. You have persevered against obstacles and overcome challenges, and you have looked ahead to step forward and make a difference in helping our entire community pull together and serve those in need. Today at commencement, it is time that we celebrate you and take this time to acknowledge all you've worked for and the goals that you've achieved. I am so proud of you and truly honored to welcome you to your new role as Western alumni. While it may be cliche to say that commencement is the start of a new journey, it's also true. And I hope that you take with you the confidence and experience that you've earned here at WCU. To the families of our grads, I just want to say thank you for sharing these great students, great people with us. I join you in being so proud of their accomplishments and equally their character. These grads have done so much to serve their communities and to lift up their fellow Catamounts. I'm grateful every day for these students and impressed with how graciously they've navigated the challenges of this year. Grads, congratulations again on behalf of the Brinson Honors College. Wherever you are today, know that you are in our hearts and minds. We are celebrating with you this important achievement. Do please keep in touch. You made a mark on this university, and I'm sure you will continue to do so. This is just the beginning of your journey as new WCU alumni. Go Cats!
To all the artists, scholars, and teachers, the members of the creative class who are graduating from the David Orr Belcher College of Fine and Performing Arts, I send you my heartfelt congratulations. I am proud of all that you have accomplished during your time here at WCU. The countless creative and scholarly works you've invested your passions and talents into evidence that you are ready to take on the challenges of the world. You are creative, passionate, and dedicated to your craft. As an artist and scholar of the 21st century, you are a survivor, just like our predecessors who dealt with their own plagues, famines, and social upheavals, but continue to create great art, explore their world, and share those discoveries with those around them. Robert Frost's poem, The Road Not Taken, ends with the lines, "Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference." As artist practitioners, scholars, and teachers, that's exactly what you have done, taken the road less traveled. Well, keep following your path. Go and take on this world. Make great art. Research great art. Teach great art. We here at WCU will be there beside you, with you, and for you. Break a leg.
Education has the power to change lives, and in the College of Education and Allied Professions, our core purpose is to make a difference in the lives of others. We strive to develop change makers who impact the region and beyond. As a first-generation college student, my experience and the road to college was different than some of my peers. I could sum up my feelings in 5 words: proud, humbled, anxious, scared, and thankful. I witnessed how much my parents valued education. Children live by example, and I want to be the best example of hard work, determination, and patience for my own daughters. During the last 13 months, we've been obliged to change our expectations, alter our realities, and rethink plans. But perseverance allowed you to continue your education, and I appreciate how hard you've worked to complete your degree. Now it is time to pursue every ambition. Go as far as you can possibly dream. Be proud of your achievements, and if you know your calling, go there. Stay on track. Keep moving towards it, even when time and sacrifice is required. Take risks and learn to accept failure. Get to work so that decades from now, you can take a look back and know you left things better than you found them. There is no question that you have a role to play, whether that's now or in the future. I know that you will contribute to this shared mission of propelling us all forward. Class of 2021, these are not easy times, but we will get through them. And with your leadership, the world will be stronger than before. Take joy in that. Congratulations and happy graduation.
There's no doubt it takes some serious dedication to earn your college degree. For some, though, an undergraduate degree is just the beginning. Tracy Hewitt graduated last night with a Master of Arts in Education with a focus on STEM. We got to go inside Tracy's classroom to see how she is using her experience at WCU to enhance how her students learn, all while making it a whole lot of fun. And we are here with Tracy now. So Tracy, as a teacher, I have to know, what was it like teaching during the COVID-19 pandemic?
It was definitely a whirlwind, a lot of adjustments and things thrown at us that we didn't expect. I taught virtually for about 8 months and then under a hybrid model and then finally back in person with my students. I've been amazed at how resilient the students have been and how much they've been able to adjust to this hard time.
And today was the first day you've been on campus as you end your program. What was it like to come to campus for the first time?
It's been wonderful. It's an absolutely beautiful campus. People are friendly, and it's really great to be here.
Final question. What would you say to all of the aspiring teachers who are graduating today?
I would say you have a journey ahead of you, but it is a really rewarding, fun, and hard journey. So good luck.
It's obvious that teachers and students have been greatly impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. But another group of folks who have been hit hard have been artists. Whether it's a Broadway show or a feature film, all forms of entertainment screeched to a halt last March. With Broadway still yet to reopen, the arts had to reinvent themselves, and our fine and performing arts students are no different. One of those students is Kelly Stancil. And while things looked a bit different this semester, her and her classmates finally got to take the stage one last time at Western Carolina University.
I have never felt more grateful for the people in my life than I have like the past couple months. I think while COVID has been really awful in a lot of ways, it's been wonderful in the sense that it's brought my class so much closer together, and I'm just really, really going to leave Western like remembering that and being so grateful for these people that I've met. I think the source of theater and the heart of it all is like being able to connect with people. I think that's the main focus, like that's your baseline. Not being able to be in front of someone to do that is really difficult. I've rehearsed over Zoom for the first couple of weeks of rehearsal, and it's very difficult to establish any kind of connection when you're looking at a computer screen. Singing on Zoom, having voice lessons on Zoom, and having the lag and the, it's just, it's been hard. I think this year, especially as a school, we have really embraced COVID. I did two productions this semester, both masked, following CDC guidelines, and as a school, in the school stage and screen, we've all had to be really resilient and really determined to make things as normal as can be in a time of complete chaos. With any live theater, you know, you have your moments where you're not 6 feet away. Well, there's a part of the end of The Foreigner where we're supposed to have a group hug with like four people. The first time we got to that part of the show in rehearsals, we all like didn't know what to do because we hadn't talked about it. So we just kind of awkwardly huddled, like as spread apart as we could. And our director absolutely lost his mind, and we ended up keeping it and doing it in the show. Just like being able to actually perform on a live stage in front of people, hearing people laugh, was kind of like, okay, we're okay. I didn't ever expect to be the commencement speaker. I actually got an email from one of my first professors from my freshman year saying like, hey, I've like low-key been following you this whole time and you impressed me then. I think you have, like, you'd have a great speech. And I told my mom, was like, I swear if you don't do it, I'm gonna be so upset. So I applied and just like kept getting through the round. And I was like, oh, this isn't like a funny thing anymore. Like, I'm gonna do it. I really wanted to focus on how our class has had to be so self-sufficient and so resilient. I think that we all should be so proud of ourselves, and I really wanted to focus on that because not everybody has these like huge support systems behind them, but regardless, we're all at graduation, we've all made it, we've all done the thing, and I think that should be really celebrated.
So joining me now is Kelly Stancil. So Kelly, what does it feel like to finally be here at graduation in person?
It's nice. I honestly, for a while there, didn't know that we'd ever make it here. So it's great. I'm having fun.
Excellent. So I got to know, what is the first Broadway show you want to go see once it's back open again?
Oh, gosh. That's hard. I think Hadestown. It won Best Musical a couple years ago. It's great. I think that would be my answer.
Excellent. So congrats on being the speaker for your ceremony.
Thank you.
How are you feeling about it?
I'm a little nervous, but that's okay. I didn't think I would ever do this, but I'm gonna do it, so
All right. Absolutely you will. Kelly, thank you so much for your time today.
You.
Good luck here in just a few minutes. Thank you so much for joining us today, Kelly. Best of luck. And thank you all for joining us today as we celebrated our 2021 spring graduates. We have waited so long for this day, and we could not be more excited for what's to come. We know so many of you couldn't be here today, but we know that you're here in spirit. Be sure to check out all of our amazing graduate features over at commencement.wcu.edu. Enjoy today's ceremony. And as always, go Cats!
Chancellor Brown, the graduating students have now assembled for the 2021 undergraduate spring commencement exercises for the Colleges of Education and Allied Professions and the David Orr Belcher College of Fine and Performing Arts.
Please remain standing as we each pause for a moment of silent reflection on the special meaning of this day. Thank you. Please join in singing the national anthem led by Ms. Claire Story, a junior in music education program in the School of Music.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say,
Claire, you may be seated. Graduates and distinguished guests, it is a pleasure and an honor to welcome each of you to the 2021 undergraduate spring commencement ceremony for the students in the College of Education and Allied Professions and the David Orr Belcher College of Fine and Performing Arts at Western Carolina University. Yes. Before we begin today's ceremony, you may notice some changes at odds with our signage on campus. In light of Governor Cooper's announcement yesterday afternoon, we are glad to accommodate and welcome our general admission guest. We also ask that our graduates keep their face mask on during the ceremony, and we ask that the audience to maintain social distancing wherever possible from those not in their party. Please allow me to recognize members of the platform party who do not have speaking roles in the commencement program. I ask them to stand and remain standing as I call their names. Please hold your applause until I have introduced them all. First, members of the Western Carolina University's Board of Trustees, Mr. Bob Roberts, Vice Chair, Mrs. Rebecca Schlosser, Secretary, Mr. John Lapoli, Mr. Kenny Messer, Mrs. Kathy Greeley, and Ms. Rebecca Hart, Student Government Association President and member of the Board of Trustees. Next, the WCU administrative staff, Dr. Sam Miller, Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs, Mr. Mike Byers, Vice Chancellor for Administration and Finance, Mrs. Jamie Rayner, Interim Vice Chancellor for Advancement, Dr. David Kinner, Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences. Representing all faculty, Dr. Cadence Otto, Faculty Senate Chair. And representing all staff, Mr. Ben Pendry, Staff Senate Chair. Please join me in recognizing these institutional leaders.
Mr. Brian Kinney, Chair of the WCU Board of Trustees, will now bring greetings from the board.
Thank you, Chancellor Brown. And thank you to today's graduates and their families, to our alumni, to university leadership, to this university's distinguished faculty and staff, my fellow trustees and members of the platform party. It's my great pleasure to bring greetings, congratulations, and well wishes from all the members of the Western Carolina University Board of Trustees. Congratulations, even after this year, you made it. During these past few years in Cullowhee, I know you've developed lifelong friendships and memories. And even over the past year, some of those were made on Zoom or WebEx or other virtual means. They're still great friends. Students, you have persevered. You've overcome. You've met obstacles in this past year that I could not have imagined when I crossed this stage a good number of years back here in Cullowhee. But in doing so, you've received not only a great education that will help you prepare for what life will bring your way, but you've developed a sense of determination that will increase your will to succeed. Now you get to go out and truly show the world what you're all about and what you can do. You are our future. The future of this wonderful mountain region, the great state of North Carolina, our nation, and our world. So, no pressure. But guys, we're dependent on you. I'm confident you're not going to let us down. As you have proven over these past 12 months, more than 12 months, of managing through a pandemic and getting a great education. If you ever wondered what the Board of Trustees does, well, I want you to know that one of the best parts of this job is bragging. Just like your parents, your grandparents, your siblings, your friends that are all around you today are joining us virtually, we brag about you a lot. We brag about your successes in the classroom, in undergraduate research, in community service, about your being players of the week for various SoCon sports, about your artwork, and about your performances. Your achievements reinforce our pride and my pride as an alum in this university. Thank you for all you do, and more importantly, for what you will do to make us proud, because we all are very proud of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kinney. We certainly appreciate your participation in our ceremony and bringing greetings from the Board of Trustees. Mr. Philip Byers, member of the University of North Carolina Board of Governors, will now bring greetings from the board and from the Office of the President.
Please do not think that I am an outsider from Chapel Hill just needing a weekend in the beautiful mountains. I too am a Catamount, having graduated in 1999 with a master's degree right on this stage, public affairs. And I'm guessing, Mr. Kinney didn't share with you what year he graduated, 1970, but I'm guessing from looking, that would be about the year most of you were born. Anybody born 1999? Thank you and congratulations. Dear God. Greetings from the Board of Governors. I am Philip Byers and I am honored to be with you today. To our graduates and their families and friends, WCU alumni, Chancellor Kelly Brown, and the Board of Trustees, the university's faculty and staff, and members of the platform committee. It is an honor and a pleasure for me to bring a message of greetings and congratulations from UNC President Peter Hans
and the staff of the UNC System Office, UNC Board of Governors Chair Randy Ramsey, and all my fellow members of the UNC Board of Governors. To you, graduates, it is a delight to look around today and see the joy in your eyes and your family members and friends, and to share your excitement with you. Collectively, we acknowledge the long hours of hard work it took for you to get to this point. We honor you today for the commitment you have demonstrated to better your life by obtaining your degree. In doing so, you not only have done something important for yourself and your families, but have also accomplished something that improves your communities and our world. As individuals, each of you has much to celebrate, but Western Carolina is reaching wonderful milestones as well, and I want to mention a few of those today. First, I would be remiss if I did not mention the dynamic leadership being provided by our Chancellor, Kelly Brown, who is getting her experiences first in-person spring commitments since the pandemic robbed us last year of this honor. I would ask that you take a moment now to thank our Chancellor for all the hard work she has performed since her arrival, and we are honored at the UNC system to call her our Chancellor at Western Carolina University. I know Chancellor Brown has been very impressed by WCU's faculty and staff and their dedication to student academics and overall student experience here in Cullowhee. One example of a great work of your faculty is a $583,000 grant from the U.S. Department of Education for an after-school program to help improve the academic skills of students at Cullowhee Valley School who speak English as another language. Also, how could I not mention your faculty, staff, and students quickly setting up the COVID-19 vaccination clinic, rapidly completing the backlog for Jackson County, and expanding to provide the vital resource to Western North Carolina. This is a historic feat for Western Carolina. Well done, Chancellor. I would add, at a recent Board of Governors meeting, I was honored as they listed all universities and how many people they had vaccinated on campus, and to say that Western Carolina was not only first, but they were first by about tenfold. So again, Chancellor, thank you. And I don't want to forget to mention what a hot commodity Western Carolina University is, as the institution once again set an enrollment record this past fall. A variety of factors are playing into our increased enrollment, including the great work of faculty and staff, as I mentioned before, and WCU status as a UNC System North Carolina Promise program, which lowers the cost of tuition and makes attending the university more affordable for students and their families. Great things are happening in Cullowhee and across the entire state of North Carolina. Collectively, our 17 UNC campuses comprise a public university system that is second to none in this country. You graduates will receive the benefit of that reputation as you go into the workforce or continue your education. As you go into living your lives, I encourage you to take the time to savor all the memories from Western Carolina University. Stay connected to this wonderful school and the people you've met. I realize those folks have become a very important part of your life, and I ask that you come back often, bring your money, invest in the great education that you have received, and make sure those who come after you will receive that great education. Congratulations, enjoy this great day.
Thank you, as always, Mr. Byers. It's always a pleasure to have you with us. We certainly appreciate your participation in our ceremony and your words of congratulations to our students. And thank you for being such a good friend to Western.
It is now my pleasure to recognize Provost Starnes, Richard Starnes, who will introduce the commencement speaker.
Each year, a graduating WCU student is selected to deliver remarks to our graduating class and guests. We invite submissions from all our graduating students, and a committee of faculty and staff from across the campus review those submissions. Without fail, the committee receives entries from remarkable students and are faced with the difficult task of selecting a speaker. I would like to thank the Commencement Speaker Committee of 2021 for their hard work in choosing a dynamic, energetic, and dedicated student speaker for this year's undergraduate commencement ceremony. The student selected for this event today is graduating from the David Orr Belcher College of Fine and Performing Arts with a Bachelor's of Fine Arts degree. This student already has a tremendous list of accomplishments of which to be proud. She graduated from Pasquotank County High School in 2017 and has majored in musical theater with a minor in dance at WCU. Outside of class, she has performed in numerous plays, including The Foreigner, Into the Woods, and Bring It On. She was also a member of the Academic Success Program. The Western Carolina community is proud to congratulate this student on her achievements, and all those we know await her in her very bright future. Graduating Catamounts, faculty, staff, and esteemed family and friends, please join me in welcoming Ms. Kelly Stansel to the podium. Before I yield the microphone, I would like to recognize Ms. Stansel with a plaque on behalf of WCU commemorating her selection as the 2021 Undergraduate Spring Commencement Speaker.
Hello. Thank you, Provost Starnes, for those kind words. Hello, fellow students, family, friends, faculty, and staff. I am honored and, to be quite honest, pretty shocked to be standing here today among all of you. I didn't know if we would get to stand in front of each other in our caps and gowns, so this day truly feels like a breath of fresh air, even under the mask. My name is Kelly Stansel, and I am a musical theater major in the School of Stage and Screen. You might recognize me from behind the counter at Starbucks, or maybe you saw me rehearsing outside for Into the Woods this semester. From dancing on the football field in a pink tutu, to walking up 9 flights of stairs in the middle of the night to my dorm room in Walker, it's safe to say that I've lived quite the life here at WCU, as I'm sure all of you have as well. I've been having flashbacks to so many memories these past couple of weeks as I walk through campus to my last few classes as an undergrad, but all of these moments have led up to this moment right now, today. We really did it, y'all. 4 years ago, when I was preparing for my high school graduation, it was a miracle that I was even going to graduate at all, much less attend a university that's 8 hours away from my hometown. When I graduated high school, my GPA was a 2.5. I was suffering from insurmountable depression and anxiety, so much so that I barely went to school. And the person I was, who once deeply cared about grades and being successful, was lost. The desire to give up felt so much stronger than continuing school. However, WCU took a chance on me. I got accepted to the university pending my participation in the Academic Success Program over the summer before my freshman year. 2 weeks before the final audition date for the musical theater program, I decided to just muster enough courage to go and see what happened. After I got accepted, I pushed through the rest of high school. When I moved to WCU in the summer of 2017, it looked like I had made a complete 360 as I completed that summer program with a 4.0. Now that I've given you my backstory, I know you're all probably thinking, here's another person to give us the classic, it gets better speech. But you're wrong, I'm not doing that. I don't actually think it gets better. It's hard, life is hard. And it doesn't really change to make things easier for us. I've had more bad days in the past 4 years than I can count. I mean, who hasn't? Especially in the past year. But to sum up my point, life is unforgiving. Is that a little dark for graduation? Maybe. But let me shed some light. What gets better is us. As my favorite human in the world, Dolly Parton, once said, People always say, but you always look so happy. Well, that's Botox. Nobody's happy all the time. But I work hard at it. We have all learned to work hard at it. Because you are sitting here today, ready to turn your tassel and then go get a margarita, or maybe a soda, I don't know, you have worked hard at it. You are resilient. We are all resilient. We got a degree during a global pandemic. I can't think of anything more iconic than that. All of this is to say that I will not reflect on my time in college and think about the days when I barely got out of bed. I will remember being a freshman and eating dinner in courtyard with all of my friends while playing Crazy Eights. I'll remember that first day by the fountain of each spring when the temperature got above the 60s. We'll remember how much joy we felt the first day we had in-person class again after the pandemic and what it felt like to sit in a circle with some of our favorite people in the world and just talk. Our resilience got us here, and no matter what your GPA is or what's on your resume at this point in your life, you deserve to be celebrated. After we leave this ceremony today, the world will still turn in the same way that it always has. It'll turn through the days that feel like they will never end, and it will turn through the days that you wish could last a little while longer. There will still be moments when you wake up and you immediately want to scream, but I hope you will give yourselves the grace to get up, go get a nice coffee, but then get to work. Lastly, if no one has told you this yet, I am proud of you. I am so proud of you for fighting the battles, whether they were inner or more tangible. Each of us have worked so hard to walk across the stage today, and I hope all of you know that the younger version of you would be so amazed and so proud to see you about to turn your tassels and embark on your biggest adventure yet. We are our biggest critics, yes, but we are also our biggest supporters, and none of us would have made it to this point without being so incredibly resilient. In addition to this self-strength, I would be remiss if I didn't acknowledge the fact that I personally wouldn't have seen this day if not for the incredible people around me, and I know I'm not alone in that. I would like to take this time to thank my parents, Angela and Jim, and my step-parents, Jim and Jason, as well as the rest of my family, for being the anchors and sometimes the bank that got me here today. I couldn't ask for a more loving or supportive family. And additionally, I am insanely grateful to the stage and screen class of 2021 for being some of the greatest people I have ever known. I have found a chosen family here at Western, and I will walk away today being the most grateful for that. Thank you to my roommate and my best friend in the universe, Leon Ray, for never letting me feel like I didn't have someone in my corner. Thank you to the professors that truly spend their time investing in the education and the well-being of their students. I've been inspired and instructed by some incredible mentors, and I leave today being a better human under their guidance. An example of this is Dr. Emily Virtue, who was my first English professor during the ASP program in the summer of 2017. Mm-hmm. I'm graduating, it's fine. Who remembered me 4 years later and sent me an email asking if I would be interested in being a commencement speaker. I never planned on doing this. But she remembered me when I was at such a fragile place 4 years ago and then reached out 4 years later, and that is the make of an educator who invests in her students past and present. I feel very lucky to have had some wonderful mentors from my time at WCU. And lastly, one more thank you to myself, because I didn't think I would ever make it here as a teenager, and I owe my past self a hug and a slap across the face for doubting her. Okay, I did it. We did it. To every slice of pizza from Courtyard, every chocolate chip cookie from Courtyard, to the dorm room naps, to all of the hours spent on Zoom calls, we are all now hotter by 1 degree. I wish all of you nothing but the best in your endeavors. You are capable of all of the big, scary things that life throws at you. And to send you off with one more Dolly Parton quote, it's hard being a diamond in a rhinestone world. You are all diamonds, and I encourage you to embark on this next chapter without settling for rhinestones. Now I'm going to sit back down so we can get this thing rolling. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Stansel, for your thoughtful remarks, your recollections of your years here at Western Carolina University. It's always a joy to hear from our student speakers. At this time, Provost Starnes will recognize the university scholars and begin today's presentations of candidates for degrees.
Chancellor Brown, it is my pleasure to recognize those students who enrolled as freshmen at Western Carolina University and who have completed their entire undergraduate careers with a perfect record, a 4.0. Having consistently met the rigorous standards of our faculty, they deserve this special recognition as university scholars. I ask the following individuals to stand and be recognized during this spring commencement. Please hold your applause until all have been introduced. Caitlin Bell. Connor Henderson, Mary Whaley. Congratulations on this outstanding accomplishment. Chancellor Brown, I now call upon the deans of the colleges to present to you the candidates for degrees. Dr. Jill Granger, Dean of the Brinson Honors College.
I ask all candidates for degrees who are members of the Brinson Honors College to please stand and remain standing. Chancellor Brown, the Brinson Honors College is pleased to present candidates who will graduate with full honors. Candidates who are graduating with full honors are distinguished by the Honors Medallion.
Dr. Kim Winter, Dean of the College of Education and Allied Professions.
I ask all candidates from the College of Education and Allied Professions to please stand and remain standing. Chancellor Brown, the College of Education and Allied Professions is pleased and proud to present candidates for the Bachelor's in Science and the Bachelor in Science and Education degrees.
Dr. George Brown, Dean of the David Orr Belcher College of Fine and Performing Arts.
Will the creative class, the artists, scholars, and teachers graduating from the David Orr Belcher College of Fine and Performing Arts please rise and remain standing? Chancellor Brown, the Belcher College is proud to present these candidates for the Bachelor of Arts degree, the Bachelor of Fine Arts degree, the Bachelor of Music degree, and the Bachelor of Science degree, ma'am.
Chancellor Brown, all candidates for degrees are hereby presented.
Thank you, Provost Starnes. I ask all faculty presidents on the platform today and in the audience to stand and remain standing in support of these graduates and as a confirmation of their meeting the rigorous standards set forth by the university. Will all faculty please stand? I now ask all Western Carolina University alumni present today on the platform and in the audience to stand and remain standing as witnesses to the conferral of these degrees and the acceptance of these students into the ranks of loyal alumni. Alumni, please rise. Upon the recommendation of the faculty by the authority vested in me by the University of North Carolina Board of Governors and the Western Carolina University Board of Trustees, and upon their completion of all degree requirements, I confer upon these candidates the degrees for which they have been recommended with all the rights, honors, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. Please join me in congratulating our newest graduates. Seated. Graduates, each of you have worked diligently, passionately, and tirelessly, earning the distinct privilege to be seated before us today. You have believed in your dreams. You have set sights on your goals.
You have weathered a once-in-a-century pandemic. You have completed all the difficult and necessary tasks to reach this day, a day that represents one of the most significant milestones in your lifetime, a milestone that makes possible a future of unlimited possibilities. It is your hard work and perseverance that is the main reason you are here today. The culmination of many long nights researching in the library, hundreds of hours of study and homework, many months in classes and internships, hundreds of hours collaborating with classmates, numerous evenings attending special events on our campus, and the list goes on and on. You hung in there no matter how tough it got, working with tutors and advisors, meeting with professors and staff. You have worked hard to make it to this day, and you are now here. As citizens of the world, yes. As citizens of the world, we face many challenges and many opportunities. Excellent health care for a changing population, innovation in an age of automation and robotics, development of sustainable, earth-friendly energies, access to affordable and quality education, construction and design of energy-efficient homes and buildings, the creation and performance of art and music, and the continual discovery in how to maintain the beauty and biodiversity of places like Western North Carolina, while simultaneously supporting a burgeoning hospitality and tourism industry. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. Graduates, it is now up to you to create the world in which you wish to live. It is your freshly born ideas that will create sustainable environments. It is your vision of the future that will eliminate poverty and hunger. It is your ability to take your educational experience and apply it to create international innovation and collaboration. And most importantly, it is your ability to believe in peace, justice, and equality that will make that a reality for all. Graduates, the future is yours and the world is counting on you. We live in exciting times, at times when employment opportunities offer unique and fulfilling experiences. Many of you have already secured interviews or job offers or plans to continue on to graduate school or have come back to school recently to complete a degree you have may have begun many years ago. As I look out at the passion and energy, the hope and resilience on the faces before me, I must say, I am so proud of you, our Catamounts. Graduates, once upon a time, we stood before you to lead the way. Today, we stand behind you, ready to follow, and we stand beside you, ready to serve as you lead us into the future. Congratulations, and go Cats! I now ask all degree candidates to step forward to receive their diplomas.
Please note that those students graduating summa cum laude, magna cum laude, or cum laude wear the gold cord. Candidates who have served or are currently serving in the United States Armed Forces wear the red, white, and blue cords. Some graduates are wearing cords, stoles, or pins denoting their participation in or affiliation with an organization. Since each individual graduate is recognized by calling their name as they walk across the stage, we ask the entire audience to respect the graduates and their families by refraining from the use of artificial noisemakers, such as air horns. We also ask that you remain seated and stay for the entire ceremony. from the Brinson Honors College, College of Education and Allied Professions, Colin Douglas Whiteley, cum laude, Ariel Dawn Glosson, summa cum laude, Destiny Grace Penzo, cum laude, Alyssa Renee Potts, cum laude, Lindsay Renee Clower, summa cum laude, Dixie Lee Laws, summa cum laude, Hannah Rose Marler, magna cum laude, Kimberly Lynn Ferguson, summa cum laude, Taylor Capri Neve, summa cum laude, Haley Marie Euler, magna cum laude, Julia Marie Trimberger, magna cum laude, Catherine Elizabeth Sherrill, magna cum laude, Cameron Cole Sanders, cum laude, Sarah Marie Martinko, magna cum laude, Cameron Joseph Williams, summa cum laude, Samantha M. Deasy, magna cum laude, Gabriel Calvin McCoy, summa cum laude, Elizabeth Ann Sellers, summa cum laude, Piper Elise Collins, summa cum laude, Lauren Emily Pearson, magna cum laude, Mary Eliza Whaley, summa cum laude, Kylie Ann Sheehan, magna cum laude, Erin Gray Haynes, cum laude, from the Brinson Honors College, David Orr Belcher College of Fine and Performing Arts, Aubrey Nicole Rinker, Kirsten Elizabeth Beach, summa cum laude, Chloe Dunn Kaler, magna cum laude, Haley Bell Hartley, summa cum laude, James Martin Powell III, cum laude, Owen Malakoch Nitzler, summa cum laude, Ashani Hadia Smith, magna cum laude, Jacob Matthew Whitlow, magna cum laude, Matthew Warren Harris, magna cum laude, Wyatt Austin Salas, cum laude, Daniel Charles Cook, magna cum laude, Jacob Dylan Kitts, cum laude, Brianna Renee Smith, magna cum laude, Micah Ray Pat, summa cum laude, Tyler Lamar Ledbetter, magna cum laude, Maddie Catherine Mabes, cum laude, Donna Jocelyn Cameron, magna cum laude, Lynette Michelle Cervero, summa cum laude, Allie Caroline Vickery Hawkins, summa cum laude, Rachel Ann High, summa cum laude, Mackenzie Nicole Squires, magna cum laude. Anna Nicole Kelly, summa cum laude. Sadie Marie Llewellyn, magna cum laude. Allison Laura Bunton, magna cum laude. Cooper Wolf Reinert. Haley Suzanne Smith, magna cum laude. Wyatt Allen Gibson, magna cum laude. Autumn Nicole James, cum laude. From the College of Education and Allied Professions, Michael Ross Wright. Jade Marie Bober, summa cum laude. Caitlin Rose Watson, magna cum laude. Caitlin Sheree Bell, summa cum laude. Samantha Natalie Hector. Holland Lee Curry. Katie Sue Bray. Victoria Danielle Sneed, cum laude. Blaine Casey Adams. Leanne Cole Jones. Lizeth Lorena Londano. Caitlin Jordan Yates. Casey Lynn Fender, cum laude. Caitlin Michelle Dodson, magna cum laude. Taylor Mariah Nicole Wellborn. Kristen Barnhart Grooms. Justin Alexander White, magna cum laude. Rebecca Marie Goris. Michael Brian Harper, Jr. Nathan Keith Kirkman, cum laude. Brandy Nicole Turner, magna cum laude. Shayla Marie Knickerbocker. Jareth Taylor Burgos. Jessica Dawn Santos. Zaria Diana Jordan. China DeAsia Brown. Lacey Nicole Jones. Jordan Paige Mills. Cheyenne Sands Goss, summa cum laude. Brianna Nicole Ward, cum laude. Carrie Michelle Plemons. Sophia Riley Kremitas, cum laude. Julia Lynn Gross, magna cum laude. Jessica French. Haley Renee Herndon, summa cum laude. Kobe Dylan Bartlett, magna cum laude. Andrew M. Spitzer, Samuel Cross Sellers, cum laude. Megan Elizabeth Hamaker, cum laude. James Andrew Davido. Grace Catherine Houston, magna cum laude. Michaela Klein Reardon. Michael Caleb Bonin Clark. Mary Grace Jarrett, summa cum laude. Catherine Murray, summa cum laude. Arielle Mayton, magna cum laude. Dylan Douglas Cruz, cum laude. Amelia Faye Borger, cum laude. Melanie Esther Jimenez. Lila K. Bishop. Carly Grace Wilcox. Jack Allen Privet. Alexander McKinley Cobb. Erica Jane Horton. Leslie Nicole Tabor, cum laude. Bailey Brooke Tavell, cum laude. Raven Cheyenne Harrell. Abigail Lee Thomas, magna cum laude. Alexis Savannah Dills, magna cum laude. Natalie May Allred. Caitlin Leanne Pruitt. Ariel Cora Ann Jackson, cum laude. Bailey Wyndham Dickerson, summa cum laude. Lauren Elizabeth Lands, magna cum laude. Mary Caitlin Dietz. Elena Ray Cook, magna cum laude. Taylor Rose Cochran. Dina Elaine Nix, cum laude. Casey McLeod Warren. Morgan Bailey DeHart, summa cum laude. Allison Marie Hedman, magna cum laude. Samantha Gray Robbins. Taylor Nicole Woodard. Charles Wesley Horde. Laura Elizabeth Steffen. Ariana Shanae Hunter, summa cum laude. Tiffany Crisp Walker. Brooke Adair Holder, cum laude. E. Bren Harrell, cum laude. Grayson Tyler Epperson. Megan Lynn Ledford. Brianna J.C. Lesmeister Vess, summa cum laude. Lily Caroline Norman, cum laude. McKinley Caroline Morris, summa cum laude. Haley Jewel Cook, magna cum laude. Brittany Ann Tuttle, magna cum laude. Reagan Victoria Carr, magna cum laude. Rebecca Grace Dover. Alexander Matthew Eplin, cum laude. Summer Destiny Howard. Destiny Lane Davis, cum laude. Josie Ann Porch, magna cum laude. Nathan Hunter Trent. Maria Lynn Miller. Destiny Nicole Martin, magna cum laude. Leah Nicole Thomas. Abigail Rose Anderson. Matthew McNeil. Dustin Edmondson. Kayla Michelle Cabe, summa cum laude. Lauren Michaela McGuire, summa cum laude. Hannah Nicole Lambert, magna cum laude. Dominique Nicole Pinckney, cum laude. Cassie Leanne Powell. Anna Smith Brown. Rebecca Ayers Church, magna cum laude. Brianna Brichet Tuft. Taylor Michelle Carter. Victoria Rose Nunez, cum laude. Zoe Glenn Dean, cum laude. Gracie Lauren Tate. Megan Kristen Dalton, cum laude. Lisa M. Brown, cum laude. Audrey Schultz Patikas, magna cum laude. Bridget Marie Librado. Anna Marie Lowe, cum laude. Ashton Hope Rogers, magna cum laude. Caroline Marie Perret, summa cum laude. Marianne Marshall Kilgore, cum laude. Nathaniel Gregory Smith, summa cum laude. Shala Z. Glover. Paige Louise Robinson, cum laude. Hannah Christina Duran, summa cum laude. Michaela Ann Luke. Misty Nicole Buchanan. Sandra Lee Massengill. Rachel Olivia Splawn, magna cum laude. Michaela Nicole Vining. Vanessa Amir Hernandez Hurst, magna cum laude. Sydney Blythe Weidenhouse, cum laude. Amy Michelle Martin. Morgan Paige Flynn, magna cum laude. Alexia Nicole Romero. Peyton Mihaela Burke, magna cum laude. Ebony N. Blake. Ian Shafi Coppage Pope. Macy Webster Shelton, cum laude. From the David Orr Belcher College of Fine and Performing Arts, Raymond Alistair Frankel. Kelly Reed Stansel, cum laude. Justin Trey Sheehan. Colby Thomas Souza. Matthew Joseph Brotherton, cum laude. Griffin Charles Watson. Lauren Justice Alford. Christina Alejandria Colón Munoz. Tucker James McGrew. Elena Ruth Nicole Newell. Jasmine Suzanne Herbert. Emily Ann Southard, magna cum laude. Fisher Neil Sherrill. Taylor Nicole Goforth, cum laude. Jenna Lee Angel Rogers, summa cum laude. Haley Nicole Wood, magna cum laude. Otis Hamilton Doolin III, cum laude. Michaela L. Triplett. Phillips Andrew Sargent Clark. Derek Owen Bass. Timothy William Stewart, cum laude. Heath Mark Ballard. Olivia Alexis Hagen, summa cum laude. Corinne Squires Taylor, summa cum laude. William Robert Slagle. Rachel Kim Sabo Hedges. Connor Fallon Knock, cum laude. Lillian Irene Davis, magna cum laude. Madeline Eugenia Franzen. Kaylin Sybil Hester. Abigail Victoria Vanash Salip, magna cum laude. Haley Catherine Caswell. Cameron Riley Tart, cum laude. Brian Scott Heindel Jr. Catherine Rose Schnurr. James Michael Roddy, summa cum laude. Nicholas Sloan Manshack. Zachary Wolf Brown, cum laude. Justin Maurice Toms. Samantha Valerie Hardin. Leon Washington Ray. Leah Celine Holland. Alexia Martin. Logic Quinn Cottrell. Elizabeth Grace Fleet. Gabriel Lyndon Spivey, cum laude. Maya Christine White, summa cum laude. Jesse Lee Nelson, summa cum laude. Madison Blair Reed. Tyler Robert Madison, cum laude. Jasmine Madison Hodgson, magna cum laude. Laura Cortez. Austin Luke Foland, cum laude. Cameron Nicole Deal, cum laude. Andrea Nicole Rappe, magna cum laude. Shelby Ann Myers, summa cum laude. Juliana Nadia Brown. Avery McClinton. Catherine Elizabeth Oden. J. Benjamin Koziel, cum laude. Rachel Catherine Spagnoletti. Isaac Robert Dye, magna cum laude. Emily Brooke Rowland, magna cum laude. Alex Joseph Midget. Sarah Rebecca Fowler. Nicholas Benjamin Gonzalez, magna cum laude. Megan Grace Wilson.
Chancellor Brown, all candidates for degrees have now been presented.
Allow all our graduates to return to their seats. So we'll just wait just a few seconds here. What did we say? Mind you. Anyway, okay. Now the moment you've all been waiting for, graduates, please rise.
Now, move your tassel to the left to signify the earning of your undergraduate degree. Congratulations. You now may be seated. You are now alumni of Western Carolina University. Yes. And now I present to you Mr. Neil Andrews, president of the Alumni Association, to greet you as new alumni colleagues.
Thank you, Dr. Brown. Good morning, Catamount family. My name is Neil Andrews, and I am the WCU Alumni Association president, but I'm also a 29-year veteran of the classroom, a fifth grade teacher. So this ceremony is a little bit more special for me today. Congratulations. It is truly my pleasure to congratulate you on your accomplishment today, and I welcome you to the ranks of Western Carolina University alumni. I want to remind you today that you make a very meaningful transition. Up until now, it's been the university's role to fill you with knowledge, to give you the skills necessary to pursue your future. Well, you leave here today as a new role, a role as a new alumni. You represent WCU. To your friends, your family, your employers, your colleagues, and to all of those who will come to know you in the years ahead. You have made memories here to last you a lifetime. But I want to encourage you not to let this be the end of your Catamount story. Today, you received an alumni lapel pin from the WCU Office of Alumni Engagement, and I encourage you to wear it and wear it proudly. Some years ago, you chose great. Now it's time to go show great. Stay connected and involved with WCU. Participate in the alumni events to keep your network strong and to make new connections. Take advantage of the services that remain available to you through the Center for Career and Professional Development. Return to WCU to share your experiences with future generations of Catamount graduates. Make WCU a philanthropic priority, as your financial contributions can make a difference in the lives of the students who are going to follow in your footsteps. But most of all, remain a part of what makes this place, the we, so special, the community. The class of 2021 will go down in WCU history as a very special class, one of incredible resolve and resiliency. The strength that you have displayed in the face of adversity during the COVID pandemic is an inspiration to us all. I look forward to continuing to serve you as Alumni Association President and hearing about all of the wonderful things that you're going to be doing. Thank you and congratulations, Catamounts!
Thank you, Neil. Thank you so much. Before we conclude, let me acknowledge some very special individuals who are a part of our ceremony today. First, I salute all members of the graduating class who are veterans, active duty, guard, and reserve members. Western Carolina University takes great pride in being a military-friendly university, and we are proud of you. Would those students please stand so that we may express our appreciation for your service? Those that are in the audience, we appreciate your service as well. Next, let me recognize the families of our graduates. Will the parents or guardians of our graduates please stand? Will the spouses and children of our graduates please stand? Continue standing. Will the grandparents and other family members of our graduates please stand? And will the special friends of our graduates please stand? Yes, remain standing. Okay, while you are standing, it is my pleasure to invite our graduates to rise and show their appreciation for you, for your love, support, and commitment for their future. Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you all. Thank you. You may be seated. Thank you. A ceremony like this does not just happen. Please join me in thanking the army of staff colleagues from every part of campus who had a part in making this ceremony a very special occasion for all of us. Let's thank them all. At the conclusion of the ceremony, we ask that the audience exit the Ramsey Regional Activity Center as quickly as possible so that we may sanitize for the next ceremony. Thanks to all of you who have joined us today to share in this momentous occasion in the life of our university. Now rise as we sing our alma mater led by Miss Story and remain standing for the recessional. Following the recessional, the ceremony will be concluded. Again, congratulations, graduates, and go Cats!